Come back to another lecture series for Gauteng Prelim 2016 paper one. Guys, thank you very much for the support that you've been showing us. And without wasting most of your time, let us just go through the question. Today we'll be doing subsection 8.3 in the Gauteng Prelim 2016 paper one. And then the question says that calculate the x coordinate or x coordinates of the points on the graph of f at x. So the graph is given by f at x is equals to x cubed minus 7x squared, at which the gradient of the tangent to f is equals to 5. Okay, so what we know is that the gradient is also equals to the first derivative of x when we're using calculus. Okay, so since this is calculus part of the question paper, we need to also consider calculus conditions of these things. So what's going to happen is that now we're going to find the first derivative. Let us find the first derivative of this thing. So the first derivative is given by 3x squared minus 14x. So this will be equal to the gradient, and the gradient is equal to 5. Then therefore, we are going to say that 3x squared minus 14x is equal to 5. Okay, then we are going to solve for x from here. Okay, so we're going to have 3x squared minus 14x minus 5 is equal to 0. Then we are going to factorize, guys. Okay, going to factorize. This is 0. So the factors of 5 is just 5 and 1. The reason I put 5 here is because 14 can only be found if we multiply 3 and 5. If you multiply 3 and 1, we can't find 14. We're just gonna find 8 or 2 or whatever. Okay, so what happens is that since this is negative, the bigger number takes the sign of the middle term, then the other number takes the opposite sign. Okay, so what's going to happen is our x value here is going to be given by negative 1/3, or our x value is going to be given by 5. Okay, so these are the x values that are going to make our gradient to be equals to 5. Okay, so they say the gradient of the tangent to the graph of f. Okay, so these are the two points. Okay, so we can find the corresponding y values and then substitute and then see if whether the gradient is actually equals to 5, and it is going to be equals to 5. Okay, so yeah, that's the end of this question. Guys, thank you very much. If you made it this far, please hit the like button and please do share the video. Thank you very much, guys.